Good morning to all. I am A. Jebin Joel, PGT Physics, working in ACS 4 Mumbai. Wish to show some demonstrations in the chapter oscillations in your 11th standard CBSE syllabus. Oscillation chapter, whenever you study this, it may be theoretically easy to know the things. But let us see some demonstrations in this chapter. When you hear the oscillation chapter, the first thing which comes in your mind is the simple pendulum. Wow, it is very nice to see all these pendulums. We have been playing in swings, in the parks. We enjoy very well in swings. The main focus, the main objective of my demonstrations in this chapter is, first part is the types of oscillations. You have studied three types of oscillations. One is free oscillation, second one is damped oscillation, and the third one is forced oscillation. Let us see the free oscillation. It is very simple to know the free oscillation from this pendulum. It oscillates freely. It has some amplitude from the mean position to the extreme position. It has some amplitude of oscillation. We can see this nothing but the free oscillation. This oscillation can be written as x equal to a sine omega t, the sine function. The body oscillates with its natural frequency. All bodies which oscillate, they have their own natural frequency. You can see after some time, the oscillation reduces, the amplitude reduces. This is because of the damped nature. The damping happens because of the external forces. Here the external force is the air resistance, air friction. After some time, you can see the oscillation cease to be zero. This oscillation has a particular time period. The time period formula we know, t equal to 2 pi square root of L by g. Based on the length from the point of suspension to the center of the bob, we take the length. Based on this length, the time period will be fixed. Now this pendulum has a fixed time period. Here we have four pendulums, all have the same mass. Of course, mass has no role in the time period. The time period is independent of mass. So, irrespective of the mass, we can see different lengths. I have kept these two pendulums with same length and these two extremes with different length, but these two lengths are same. Now let us see the forced oscillation. I will show how the frequency is transferred or energy is transferred from one pendulum to another pendulum by the phenomenon called forced oscillation. Now you can see very well the second pendulum, which I have not given external force, but external force is given by this pendulum. Its amplitude is now becoming zero. This is vibrating with maximum amplitude. So they mutually share their energies. Now this is stopped and this amplitude is maximum. Now this is transferring the energy to the other pendulum. It is oscillating now. Now this is stopped. Its energy is completely transferred to the other pendulum. So we can see here a kind of conservation of energy also by the phenomenon called forced oscillation. So the condition for forced oscillation is two pendulums, they should have the same time period. For that, they should have the same length. Then the frequencies can be interchanged very well. So if I say in brief, we have seen free oscillation here, forced oscillation here, then interchange of energy in forced oscillation. This is also called coupled oscillation. Now let us see how the frequencies of two bodies can be matched and explaining about the uniform circular motion as a simple harmonic motion. Now let us see the concept of frequency matching. Here the pendulum is oscillating. I will find the frequency of this oscillation. Let me start the time period of oscillation. Start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it has 19.9 seconds for 10 oscillations. So if I take it as 20, roughly it has a time period of 2 seconds. Now let me check the time period of this object which is in uniform circular motion. This object is in uniform circular motion, which is done by the motor. I will check the time period of this also. Different speed, different time period I will get. I increase the speed of this, increase it, decrease, decrease. So let me check the time period of period for this case. Let me check the time period for this case. For this speed, this has a particular angular speed. I will start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We can see the time period 19.7. For the pendulum, we have seen 19.9. It differs by 0.2 seconds only. Doesn't matter. Almost the time periods are equal. Now, if the time periods are equal, we know the formula for frequency. Frequency equal to 1 by time period. So, frequencies are matched. So, what is there in frequency matching? It's a very important thing to understand the uniform circular motion as a simple harmonic motion. We will see a very interesting phenomenon, demonstration of these two bodies going with the same frequency. As such, you cannot see here, I am going to demonstrate that using the projection of this object on this screen. And we can see the two bodies whose frequencies are matching. What we can see here is a body which is undergoing a uniform circular motion. I project that body along the diameter. We can see as if the body is going along a linear path on the shadow. We can see the shadow of this body which is linear. It is amazing. The linear simple harmonic motion, it is arrived from the uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion, when we project the body along the diameter, it acts like a simple harmonic oscillator. This has a particular time period and frequency. We already found the time period and frequency of this body undergoing uniform circular motion. Now, I plug this simple pendulum bob to oscillate. And this is also a linear simple harmonic motion. We can see another pendulum there. In the beginning, the oscillation started same time, but the oscillations are not matching. The reason is they have different time periods because of their different lengths. Now what I am going to do is, we are going to demonstrate the two bodies having the same frequency. The one which is actual simple pendulum, which is executing simple harmonic motion, and the another one is undergoing uniform circular motion. Shall we see whether the frequencies will match? Shall we see the frequencies matching? For that, I will just stop this two pendula. I will just start the motion of this motor. We can see the frequency matching of these two bodies, though they are performing different kinds of motion. This is performing uniform circular motion. This is performing simple harmonic motion. But they are almost looking together when we see the shadow part of that. The interesting factor here is the two bodies, if you see the shadow of that, the two bodies are performing linear simple harmonic motion only. So what we can conclude here is the frequency of this body undergoing uniform circular motion and the simple pendulum, they are equal. So in the same manner, I have arranged the spring oscillation. Here also I have taken the spring oscillation in such a way that the frequency of this spring oscillation is same as the frequency of the body which is undergoing uniform circular motion. The spring is going up and down. It is up and down motion, and it is again simple harmonic. Again the frequency matching concept and the projection of uniform circular motion along the diameter is nothing but the simple harmonic motion we can see here. Let us see the path of the body which is in uniform circular motion and the spring oscillation. What you can see here is the tone generator. It will generate frequencies of different values, which you can see here. Now this frequency is 20.6 hertz. This is 98 hertz. Like that, we can choose any desired frequency. So this is the advantage of this tone generator. C0 16.35 hertz, D is 19.45 hertz, F1 43.65 hertz. Like that, we can choose any desired frequencies using this tone generator. This is just producing a kind of sine wave here. Here this frequency is chosen. It's a very high frequency, 7459 hertz. So we have the number, frequency number in our hand in the form of tone generator. Now what is the use of this? This can be used for demonstrating the frequency matching with different objects. For example, here I have taken water and it is kept over the speaker, and the tone generator that generates a particular frequency is given to the amplifier, and from amplifier it is coming back to the speaker, and the speaker membrane will vibrate with the particular frequency which I choose here in the generator. The water column
water will not vibrate at all frequencies. It vibrates at all frequencies, but it won't produce resonance. What is resonance? If two frequencies are matching, the object will vibrate with maximum amplitude. The frequency I choose in the generator and the water vibration, if they are matching, the water column will vibrate with maximum amplitude. That we can see from this demonstration. Shall we start? I choose a frequency 16.0 Hz. I choose a frequency 16.35 Hz. It is vibrating, it is vibrating. Yes, this is producing a resonance, and we can see the resonant frequency makes the water column vibrates in this pattern. A body can have different resonances. Now I choose this frequency. It is resonating with different pattern. We can see the change in pattern because the resonance frequency is changed. Now this is not vibrating only. The reason is the frequencies are not matching. It has gone beyond the resonant frequencies. Another frequency, no, not matching. 49 Hz, not matching. 43 Hz, not matching. 233.1 Hz, not matching. So what we can see here is, the body will vibrate at resonant frequencies. It can have more than one resonant frequencies also. So resonance occurs if two frequencies are matching. I think you understood very well. I have made the frequency of the tone generator matching with the frequency of vibration of the water in this vessel. One more time, I will demonstrate. Yes, this frequency is matching. It is C0, 16.35 Hz. It is matching on this frequency. Yes, this is also matching. It is nearby that frequency. It is 17.32 Hz, but the frequency of vibration is different. The pattern is different. Yes, this is also matching 20.60 Hz. So it is matching on low frequency range. The vibration is maximum on low frequencies. So that means the water column has its own resonant frequencies which are in lower ranges. In higher ranges, the frequencies are not matching. It is 110 Hz. It is not matching. Likewise, at higher frequencies, there is no resonance. So, frequency matching concept is very important to know the resonance phenomenon. And let us see some more demonstrations based on this. So this keyboard generates different frequencies based on the frequencies I choose. This is C scale. C. It will produce a particular sound with that frequency. Another frequency. Another frequency. So I can play with the frequencies. Different sounds will be created, and their collection is nothing but the music. So like that, the keyboard has different frequencies, notes that we can choose. Now, what I will do here is, I will match a particular frequency with the frequency of vibration of this plate. I am pouring this rava particles here on this plate.
I have connected the keyboard output to this plate. So if I play a note, this plate will vibrate with this frequency, but the frequency of this vibration of this plate and this note, they are not matching. Let us find which note is matching. It's not matching. Not matching. Not matching. Yes, what we can see here is a beautiful pattern. And how this pattern is formed? It is nothing but the stationary wave generated because of this resonance. The stationary wave generated on this plate has node. These are the nodal points where the vibration is zero. And here vibration is maximum, the particles cannot stay there. Here the vibration is minimum, it is almost zero. So such kind of pattern we will get at resonance. Now if you try for different frequencies, we will get different resonance patterns. And let us see another pattern using another frequency from the keyboard. What a nice pattern, and it is matching with this frequency, and on this keyboard it is G scale. This G scale is matching with the frequency of this vibration of this plate, and which produces a particular pattern. So this phenomenon is based on the resonance concept. So at this 123.50 Hz, we get another resonance, and the pattern is looking very beautiful. As I already told, where the accumulation of rubber particles are more, there the nodes of the stationary waves are formed. And here the antinodes are there, thereby the particles cannot stay there. The vibrations will be maximum here. So this is a very beautiful demonstration to show the resonance phenomenon. The plate is vibrating with 123.50 Hz as that of the tone generator frequency. The two frequencies are perfectly matching, and this beautiful pattern is formed. So let us see the resonance pattern formed on this plate by induced vibration, nothing but the forced vibration. So a perfect pattern of stationary wave is formed because of the resonance. Again, these are the nodal regions and these are the antinodal regions of this vibration because of this resonance phenomenon. Different shaped plates, different patterns will be formed.